So this is a Google Docs training. Thanks everybody for joining, those who can be here. And if you're not joining the live training, this is a recorded version of it on my screen here. You guys see my screen?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great.
Yep.
I'm just gonna start. So this is my desktop here. I don't really have anything on my desktop. It's pretty blank. I'm gonna move this to the trash. So I'm gonna start a new window, and then just kind of show the different ways that we can open up our Google Drive and documents just from scratch. So I'm assuming that everybody can open up a window from their computer. If you can't do this, or I'll walk us through it. But at any point, if you have, if I assume incorrectly that we can do something that we can't, then just stop me, and I will gladly show the, you know, be more detailed about it. So I'm gonna open up a new window here. And it's going to take me to my Google Chrome window, which is my default. And so from here, I can go into my Google Drive or my Google Documents by going to the right of my screen. And there's a grid here. It's a 3x3. So there's like 9 little dots here, and this opens up the Google Apps. And if I click on it, Google Apps will drop down. There's a drop down window that will take me to all the Google apps that are available with my Google account. So that's Gmail, it's Drive, it's Docs, Sheets, Calendar, all this stuff. And you can see if I scroll down, there's a lot more that maybe we weren't even aware of. I know I was. So the one I'm gonna go to now is Google Drive. And so Google Drive contains, it's kind of like a cloud-based system. So it's a storage, it's a free Google storage. It's kind of what a cloud system is for your Google account. And in it, you can store things like documents, images, Excel spreadsheets, any kind of files that you need to store. Your Google Drive can store that in. So I've opened it up, and as you can see, mine has already, under my Drive, there's a bunch of documents already highlighted or already in there. I'm just gonna really quick open up a new window and show you another way to open up your Google Drive or Google Documents. So if you say, you know, a lot of people might not be aware of this little icon over here on the right, this little grid next to your Google account icon. Let's say you just forget, just a general rule of thumb, actually Googling anything brings a strong search result. So if I just decided to say, oh, I don't know how to open up my docs, maybe I'll type it into Google and type in Google Docs. And if I just type that in, you can see that one of my search results is Google Docs. And in fact, since I'm already linked into my account, if I click on it, it's gonna open up my Google Docs. So one of my search results was Google Docs. By clicking on it, I can also open up my Google Docs. Or if I decided to type in Google Drive, which is the one I was kind of wanting to go into. It's probably the first one. So you could see search result came up. If I click on it, it'll take me to this screen, and I can click on go to Drive, and it will take me to my Drive. So if you forget about the icon again, just type it into Google and it'll take you there. Okay, now that I'm in my Drive, you could see that there is a bar with a bunch of folders on the left side of my screen right here. It says priority, my Drive, shared with me, recent, starred, and trash. So the main one it takes you to is My Drive, which is kind of like the equivalent of your computer. If you have like a My Documents folder, this is kind of the equivalent of that. So under My Drive, it'll show me all the documents that I have. Another one to note is the one right under it, Shared With Me. So a lot of times, like some folks were saying, that you'll get an email, somebody shares an annual document with you or a form, and that will be under this folder, Shared With Me. You can see I have many folders or documents that people have shared with me. Just two to point out there. If I wanted to open up a document that I already had stored, I would simply click on it under My Drive. But let's say I wanted to create a new document. There's a button right here that says New right above in the top left of my screen, right above the My Drive. So if I click on that, it's going to prompt me for a couple of options under a window. And you can see that I can go to a folder, I can upload a file, or I can go under Google Docs, Google Sheets. And if I wanted to go under Google Sheets, I would click on it and it would take me directly there and I would start a new document. And so once I've started this document, this is sort of the basics of Google Docs here, where I would give my title. So title, I would type it up to this document. And that would sort of be my first approach here. Another first approach might be to give this document a title in itself. And as you can see on the top left of my screen, it says Untitled Document. And if I hover over it, it says Rename. So if I click on it, I can rename it, and it kind of just goes to the first words I said, but maybe I want to name this like Google Docs Training. And that's the title I would give this document, Google Docs Training. So now this Google Docs Training document is saved under My Drive automatically. That's another thing with Google Docs or Drive, anything with Google, it sort of saves automatically to your drive, to your computer. It is good to label it, because even though it does save, sometimes if you don't label it, you'll have a bunch of untitled documents, and that can be pretty confusing because you don't know what they are. So once you've titled it here, another maybe a convenient thing for you to do is right next to the title is a star. And Janet and I and Lillian were talking about this earlier. A lot of times we can't find documents. We can't find emails, right? It's very difficult at times because there's so many, kind of get lost. One way to mitigate that is to star this document. And when you star it, you can see that when I click it, the star is highlighted in yellow. And what this does is put it into the star folder in My Drive, so it's a specific folder. So if I wanted to find this document easier, I could go into the starred folder and find it a lot quicker than navigating My Drive, which has a lot of documents. Another thing you could do right next to this star is a folder icon that says Move. So you can move any document to any sort of folder or location within Google Drive. So if I click on move, you can see that there's a window that pops up. Now there's a couple of options on this window. On the bottom left is an option to create a new folder to house this new document in. I could do that. I could create a new folder. Maybe in the future, I'm going to have more trainings. So I'm going to maybe create a new folder and title it my trainings folder. And under this, and then once I click this checkbox, I create this folder. And you can see that there's a title here. And once I do that, the folder is created. And maybe now I want to move this new document with my Google Docs training here. I could do that. So that's a way to also organize yourself, is to create a folder to house different things in. Now, if I already had a folder, let's say, and so I, the top of the screen here has an option to go back, and maybe I had a folder already under, let's say, a document that's shared with me. And sure enough, I have a digital literacy team folder right here. And under that is even another folder that says training, notes, tools, resources. And under that folder is another folder that says training outlines. And maybe I wanted to move this document there. So you can see that we can create almost an infinite number of folders and places for documents. And sort of a rule of thumb is, like, the more, you know, folders or compartmentalize you have your documents, the easier they are to find, right? But, you know, if we're not there yet, and it's, we just want something simple, we don't use Google Docs a lot, and we just want one folder to find everything, maybe that star option is the best place for you. And if I just real quick, if I go back to my drive, this is a screen that appears as soon as I go into my drive. I can see on the left here that under the My Drive folder, there is a starred folder. And sure enough, if I click on that starred folder, that Google Docs training document that I starred is right there. And so I just wanted to show you that what that star does. And that is very similar to Google email. So if you ever have an email, I'm just going to briefly say this, and there's always a star next to it on the left. You can click on that star and it'll put it into a star folder, which allows you to find it easier. Okay. Any questions on any of that? I feel like that was a mouthful, and I've been talking for a while.
No, that was good.
Okay. Great. So I'm going to just go through the basics of Google Docs right here. It's very similar to Microsoft Word. So this is the document I created. I showed you how to give it a title, give it a name. Now this is a title that I've written out. Now if I wanted to make this font bigger, these are some basics you guys already probably know, so I'm going to go through them pretty quickly. Stop me again if there's a sort of a basic icon or tool that you didn't know and you'd like to explore more. So if I wanted to, you know, make it bigger, I would highlight it, and then I would click on the font size right above here in my sort of tabs up here. And actually, maybe we should go through this real quick. So when you open up Google Docs, you'll see that aside from naming it, there's going to be all these little tabs or menus, such as File, Edit, View, Insert, Format. And when you click on one of them, it has a lot more options. So these are kind of your best friends here. That will allow you to edit your document in various different ways. You can add images. We're going to talk about them. And then right below that that menu bar is another bar that has a lot of different icons that is very similar in the sense that it allows you to edit your document in various different ways. This is sort of the more pop, these are like the most popular ways to edit your document. That's why they're kind of up here by default. So real quick, I'm gonna highlight this. If I wanted to change my font size, I would go to the font size icon right up here. And you could see it gives me options to go all the way, make it very large. I think I can even type it in if I wanted to. Say I want number 16 font size. Yep, and plug that in. I wanted to make it maybe bigger by bolding it or underlining it. I would go to the underline icon. Or if I wanted to, there's also an option right next to the font, the type of font, which is another option. You could change this to, let's say, Cambria, if you wanted to. So now it's a Cambria font. Maybe that's something you like better. Right next to it, though, it says normal text. So these are styles of text. So you can give it a title, which might be appropriate because it is a title. And it sort of has it the default style already, or like a heading, different kinds of options. So this is for my title. Now let's say I wanted to center this title. Let me just say it's the title is Alex, or Google Docs training. And I wanted to center this because I would click on that menu with all these icons right above, and sort of to the middle right is, as you can see, is left align, center align, right align. Center align is the one we're looking for here. And something I wanted to point out is there are many icons in Google Docs as there are in Google Word or any sort of platform that you edit forms. I really encourage you guys to take your time, and what you can do is hover above the icons, and a lot of times they'll tell you a little bit of what they do. So if I hover under the B, it says bold. So I can probably take a good guess that it's gonna bold my text. If I hover over the little marker here, it says highlight color. So if I wanted to highlight my text, I would probably click on it. So I know like a lot of these icons can be overwhelming because there's so many of it, but I really encourage you guys to, just take your time exploring them. You know?
Alex, can I ask a quick question? I struggle with spacing, line spacing. I don't know where it is. I keep looking and I never find it. So maybe you can quickly show us.
Okay. And then this is a good segue into my next point here. And if I wanted to go back to line normally and maybe shrink down my font size. So if you are unaware or not sure, because I said there's like hundreds of different icons, things to click on to edit this form, a good thing to do is on the first menu line here, you'll see under like next to file, edit, view, all the way to the right is the help icon. So if you click on help, it actually does just that. It opens down a menu and it's kind of like a search menu. So Janet just said, and this is a good point, I'm sure most of us have encountered this, where we don't know where this button is, where this icon is to, but we do know what we want to do. And Janet said she wanted to, was it space? Did you say, Janet?
Line spacing, yes.
Line spacing. So I'm just going to click that, just like I type that in, just like I would into a Google search. So I'm going to type in line spacing, and you can already see that there's some search results that come up. So this is a search bar within Google Docs that allows you to explore it. So line spacing, sure enough, it's first one on here. And if I click on it, it will actually do it for me, but because I didn't have anything selected, let me give you another example of that. I already have a document created under right here. So if I, this is just another document I created. Let's say I selected my, this that I wanted, and I was like, I don't know where line spacing is. Again, I'd go to help, type in line spacing, and here it is. If I wanted single or double, maybe I'd click one. Maybe I wanted double, I'd click on that one. And you could see it did it for me.
Great.
This is just a general sort of helpful tab there, but let's explore line spacing a little bit more. So usually if you want to edit, a lot of times a good place for stuff like that might be the edit tab. So let's try clicking on edit. I don't see it there. It's probably not under file. It might be under insert or format is my guess. Yep. So the format, I guess, is part of line spacing. Okay. So again, just by hovering on some of these things, they're going to show you exactly what are some of the options. And sure enough, when I go to format, and I don't have any of this stuff memorized, guys. So that's why you're seeing me in real time look around for it a little bit.
Yeah.
But when you see me look around for it, we can sort of cancel out some stuff that doesn't make sense, right? If I go under edit and I see it's not undo, it's not redo, it's not paste, so that's not the right tab. I'm going to keep going, right? Until I finally get to format and I see something that says line paragraph spacing, and sure enough, there it is, line paragraph spacing.
Mm-hmm.
And it asks me if I want single, 1.5, double, add spaces before paragraph. So there's all these options, Janet. Is there something, did that answer your question? Or is there?
Yeah, it looks real obvious right now. So, but thank you for, for that.
yeah, no worries. Okay. So there's some basic sort of tools that I kind of wanted to ask you guys to make this a little bit more interactive. What are some little icons or tools that you already know how to use in Google Docs? Is anything anybody use all the time? That's a pretty easy one. That
bold, color.
Nice.
Font size.
So here's
quite bold. A few of those. Yeah.
Yeah, here's color, text color. Yep, that's a good one. Change the text color.
Centering.
Centering, yeah. Bullets.
Bullets, yep, which is right on the, so these are all within the sort of popular bar here. And real quick, I just want to point out, because I was doing some of this stuff, I'm gonna just do the bullets. And here's my bullets. Now this I was doing really quick as an example to go with you guys, but I don't really want to keep this, you know, I was just kind of doing it. I'm sure you guys are aware, but this is a really helpful tool for me, is the undo button. So if I ever wanted to undo some of the edits that I just made, like this bullet or this text color, all the way to the left, I'll see of the menu icons bar, I'll see the first one is undo, and it's sort of an arrow, a curved arrow. And if I click on it, you can see that it undoes the bullet. If I click on it again, it undoes the color. If I click on it again, it keeps undoing until the last, to the first thing. Now let's say, you know what? I did like that color that Janet's, or that Liz said, I'm gonna redo that. I wanna keep that red color. So I'm gonna redo. So it's undo and redo are pretty good tools there.
Great.
Go ahead, Liz, do you have a question?
Yeah, I was looking here for, I do a lot of templates for my clients, And I was looking on this one for inserts. You know, you can insert a cartoonish character that usually works for my clients. Where is it on here?
Yeah, that's a great question. Because that's an easy one, I'm going to go over that right now. Your vocabulary that you just said, insert, that might even be a good place to start, right? Because sure enough, there's an insert tab up here, insert. And if you go to insert, you can see it drops down. There's images, there's tables, there's drawings. So images is probably what we're looking for. And you can upload one from your computer if you have it. You can search the web. You can see from your photo, you can go to your photos or your drive. You can even have, there's a camera option, so you can take a picture from your camera on your computer. Real quick, I'm going to do the search the web one because that's probably a popular one. If I click on that, you can see that there's a tab here that opens up to search the Google website. And if I click on, let's say, a cat, I want an image of a cat. I'm going to search that, click enter. And sure enough, a bunch of cat images pop up. Let's say I like the first one. I'll double click on it. And it should insert it somewhere. There it is. Just took a little bit, but it's going to insert that image of a cat right there. And then I could edit this. If I click on this image within my document, I can make it smaller or bigger. I can, wrap the text around it if I wanted to. All these different sort of editing options. Okay, and then a real cool, another way to do that I think is a great tool that I didn't really know until recently, is the Explore function. On the bottom right of the Google Docs is this icon that says Explore. Can you guys see that right here?
No.
So if I click on Explore, it opens up this menu, and Explore sort of interacts with your document. So it'll look at your document's text, maybe the images, the content, and explore your document. And so sure enough, Explore, the menu says, oh, I see you have Google Sheets written on here, Google Docs. It gives me related search engines. I think one of the more important things about Explore is, like Liz was saying, we can explore or search for images. Let's say I type in cats again. And I type in cats, and now Explore allows me to search for cats directly on the web, which is Google Web. And you can see the Wikipedia popped up as the first one. There's other results that pop up, and I can keep scrolling down. And let's say if I wanted to go, and then I could easily click on this website, and then another screen pops up. And this website was Wikipedia. So if I like the first paragraph from Wikipedia and I wanted to use it as a base type for my essay, maybe I'll copy. Maybe I should show you the guys that are. So I'll highlight the text from the website and I would copy it. I would right click and copy it and go back to my documents. I would paste it. And there it is. You can also, I'm going to undo that real quick just to show you guys. I pasted it straight from the format or the words from the Wikipedia website, but if I right click, you can see there's two paste options. Paste, so the first one is to paste straight as you copied it from the website, and the paste without formatting, if you click on that, it actually formats to your Google Docs format, which is pretty helpful if you don't want to change your format. So if I click on that, you can see that it keeps the same formatting as my Google Documents. Now, let's say if I wanted to, this is kind of a cool feature of Explore is that if you're helping your clients out, you know, write an essay or something like that, and they need to create a footnote, you can actually click on the right of the search engine under Explore, and it says cite as footnote, and it will cite that as a footnote underneath here. You can see that now it's a footnote, and that'll give it like a good reference or a citation, that's what I meant. So you can see that it has options for MLA, APA, Chicago type of citation. So I've done citations in the past with clients, and this is just an easy way of doing that. So Explore will also allow you to, beside the web function, like if I wanted that image of the cat, it would allow me to go to images or explore things within my drive. So I just wanted you guys to see that that icon or function under Google Docs. It's a pretty helpful one. Okay. I'm gonna undo a bunch of the stuff that I just did because I don't need it. Okay, I wanted to talk about, okay, somebody's Rose or Ross is returning. I wanted to quickly highlight this function as well, because I think it might be helpful for some of our clients who have different kinds of physical disabilities and maybe aren't able to type as easily. There's also the option to voice type under Google Docs. So it's under, it will be under tools. So if you click on tools, which is, you know, in the menu bar here, tools, and it opens up the window. And if I scroll about midway, it says voice typing. Now this will do just that. So if I click on that, and right here on, you could see that this little window popped up with a microphone icon on the left, and it says click to speak. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do to show you guys. So if I wanted to type what I'm saying right now, then I would, or if I wanted to use this icon, you could see it's doing it. Anyways.
Hey, that's great.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
If I wanted to, give it a period at the end, then it will do that too. So I'm gonna give you an example. So I am recording, period. This is a new sentence, period. New line. And so you can see that it jumps down, but it also interacts, and I'm gonna stop doing this because it's gonna keep recording. It also will allow you to interact with it when you're not recording. So you can just go back and let's say accidentally you said it didn't record correctly. You can just delete it and edit it. So I think this would be helpful for some clients that might not like to type, prefer voice. Any questions on any of those sort of more advanced tools?
I also had one, Alex, that I use a lot with my students for presentation. I do insert like images, as well as just drag and drop images from Google search.
Okay, so you're saying you drag and drop, that's your preferred way of inserting images?
And or insert if they have a saved image on their desktop that they want to insert.
Right.
For like presentation purposes.
So like insert, and then you're talking about going to images and then like upload from your computer?
Yeah, or drive or wherever they've saved them.
Right. Okay. So I'm going to, just as an example, upload from your computer, and this will take you to your computer's folders where you might have an image. Let's say I got, looks like I got this ICS logo. So I'm going to double click on that. And it says creating images. And sure enough, it appears in my documents. So you can pull it from there. And another thing that Lillian was saying is that you can drag and drop an image. That is correct. You could do that. So let's say I was on the internet and I'm going to use this explore function to show you that. And I want an image of a cat. Let's say this explore menu was actually a different window. But I can also click on this cat image and you can see I click on it and hold it and then drag it over to my documents and drop it there. And then sure enough, it will populate. Okay, that's enough for the cats. Okay, and then I wanted to answer Laura's question about saving from PDF. So if I have a, let's say this document right here you're looking at was created under Google Docs. So I wanted to save it or convert it to another document type. I'm going to click on the file button on the top left of my screen. And under it, it says download. When you hover over download, there's another window that says Microsoft Word, PDF document, plain text. These are different formats that you can save under. The most popular one to save under in order to send to people is PDF document. And the reason why is because it's sort of very standard. Most people can open it and view it. Now, Microsoft Word is another one. However, some people don't have Microsoft Word or they have a different version of Microsoft Word that won't allow it to view it. That's usually not the case with PDF. So PDF is one of the most popular, if not the most popular format to save it under. So if I click on PDF document, so it's going to download under PDF. So now this Google Docs document that I made is going to be downloaded as a PDF. And sure enough, on the bottom left of my screen, I can see it appeared downloaded. I'm going to click on it. I'm going to open it. By clicking on it, it opens to a new screen. Now, this might be something you guys are familiar with. A lot of times when you click on a document or download it, it opens up into a new screen. Now, from here, it shows you, it sort of previews you how that document is going to look like. So this is how the document is going to look like as a PDF. However, it's not quite saved as a PDF. It's just sort of downloaded. Now, if I wanted to save it, on the top right of this window is a print button right here. You can see by however it says print. I'm going to click on print. I know this is sort of counterintuitive because I don't want to print it, but this is actually a very popular function here. And so another window pops up. You can see it's previewed. I'm not going to print it, but under right where it says destination, it says save as PDF. And if you don't have that highlighted, it might actually say print. You want to look for save as PDF or save. And so sure enough, if I do that and I click on the bottom right, save, it's gonna prompt me to what folder in my computer do I want to save it under. And right now the default is documents, but let's say I wanted to save it somewhere else, maybe in my desktop. I would click and change that location to say desktop, and then I would just click save. So now it was converted, it was downloaded as a PDF, and I saved it in my desktop. And if I show you guys, sure enough, there it is in my desktop, the only document there. I double click it and it will open as a PDF. Now, real quick to go the other way, Okay, there it is. And this, within this, you can't really, you can edit this document by stuff like fill and sign tools, stuff like that, but it's sort of permanent. Anyways, we could get into PDFs some other time. I think it's worth looking into. I'm gonna go back. And we're kind of out of time here. You guys have like 5 minutes maybe?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay, cool. Sorry about, I think we got started a little late. All right, let me go back to my screen here. And Laura, you also said, help me remember, you said you wanted to go from Word to Google Docs or Docs to Word or something?
Yeah, like annual plans generally are, you know, in the network as Word documents. And so if someone didn't have Word on their computer, but they wanted to edit it, it's hard to do that in PDF, right? So could they just upload it to, you know, their Google Drive and then edit it in Google Docs? Is that what you would do?
Yeah, you don't even have to upload it to Google Docs. You can just open it in Google Docs from your document. I'm going to show you how to do that right now. So if we go back to our, you can either go from your documents or your Drive. Sorry if it's a little loud in the back of it. Can you guys still hear me?
Yes.
Okay, sorry about that. So I'm going to, if I'm already in my Google Docs, I can go to File, Open, and this is with my Drive. Oh, I'm sorry. So you can see that a new window opens up and there's a couple of options. You can go to your Drive, which is your Google Drive, shared with me. I talked about that at the start, all these stuff, but you can also right in the middle, it says select the file from your device. So I'm gonna click on this button right here in the middle. And it says the select the button from my device means the device that I'm using, which is my laptop computer. So the document under my computer. And as you can see, a new window pops up with the documents stored in my computer. So under documents, I think I do have a Word document here. Yes, I have an Alex Claro resume, 2016. This was pre-ICS, so forgive me, everybody. I see it's a Word document, and I'm going to show you guys what happens if I click on that Word document. It's obviously not a Google Doc. Let's see what happens. So it's uploading so that it can upload and open to Google Docs. And sure enough, it is able to open up in Google Docs. Now, to Laura's point, this, just because I know my resume, this format has been edited a little bit. Like usually it's only one page, now it's two, because the Word format is different than the Google Docs format. So that is something to keep in mind when you have to open up a Word document or any document into a different format, like a Google Docs, it might change the format a little bit. And so you can fix the format within this, you know, I can select here and maybe backspace and, you know, get my bullets back in line a little bit, a little better. But it will change because it's a different format. Now, a way to sort of like freeze or stop the changes, sort of to share it in one like language, is to save it as a PDF. Once you've downloaded it from Word to Google Docs, and now you created all these edits, maybe saving it as a PDF, like I just showed you how to do, will sort of help freeze it or like not edit it as much anymore, if that's what you're looking to do. So that when you send it to somebody, they can view it and stuff like that. You know, Something else that you could do though is if you had trouble, you know, if let's say you were able to open up, if you had a Word document, let's see if I go to recent. If you had a Word document and you could actually copy and paste the text of your documents, and then just put it into a Google Docs and then edit it that way. So if you're having a tough time sort of converting like Microsoft Word or PDF to Google Docs, there's always the option to just simply, and this is kind of a more brute way of doing this, maybe sort of a cheat code way, just sort of simply by copying all of your text. And then I would just open up a new document. Sorry, give me one second. Here we go, blank document, and then just paste it on there, and then edit it that way. Laura, did that kind of answer your question? I know it's not.
No, this has all been really helpful because I don't use Google Docs or the Drive enough. So this is super duper helpful.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Solid.